Hey, pass the gabagool. It's we're in the Craigslist missed connections, and it's the New Jersey edition. Yeah.
All right, Party Animal Hillside, North New Jersey. Two trans girls here looking to PNP. Slopes only, you supply, looking for now. I do not know what slopes or PNP are, but I'm going to guess PNP means pee and poop, and slopes means toilets. These are just two girls looking for a bathroom in North New Jersey. Somebody help them out, you know? All right, let's try and figure out what this person's trying to say. Missing Will and Grace, buddy. You were the best. You were the top, the best, greatest friend I ever had. Our favorite show, Will and Grace. You always said Jack and I were twins in every way possible. Now more than ever, I'm like Jack. Bottom of the pay scale at work. I miss and need you. You, Will, you were always the top, and I was always the bottom. If you see this, I'm free tomorrow from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. I'd love to see you and catch up. I hope you're still the top. Of course, I'll always be the bot Tom, raw, honestly. As ever, I hope you remember what I look like. I'm still cute as a button, and I hope you're still rugged, manly, and at the top of your game. All right, this one's an actual missed connection. Waitress Manahawkin. Long shot here that you see it, but we smiled at each other unlimited times on Saturday late afternoon, early evening, as I was patron and you were the hot waitress. You know why I couldn't talk to you, but just curious if you'd like to chat. If this is you, tell me which restaurant and describe yourself. Okay, so there's two main things that stand out to me here. We smiled at each other unlimited times. That means that you were making eye contact. Like, the waitress was in the back getting food from the kitchen and she was still smiling at you. So I don't know. Unlimited is just the wrong, it's just incorrect. And then, you know why I couldn't talk to you. I'm guessing this guy was like out to dinner with like his partner and I don't know about this one, guys. All right, so we've got a couple posts. I'm pretty sure they're from the same person just from a couple context clues. This person titled Gunnison Sandy Hook, late 40s male in good shape, would love to find a female to go with, just so not feeling like a creep hanging alone. M seeks F for Gunnison visit. I'm a 50-year-old male who has never been to Gunnison. I don't want to be that creep who goes alone, seeking a female to join me on Thursday 7:15. I am down to earth, local in Monmouth County. So, I just feel so bad for this guy. I mean, first, okay, so these posts were both posted on the same day. One of them says late 40s, one of them says 50-year-old. I'm guessing the late 40s was maybe the second one. He was like, oh, nobody wants to date a 50-year-old. Late 40s is a lot more, you know, youthful and vibrant. And then the whole just, like, I don't want to be the creep who goes alone. Like, it's just sad. I feel bad. Like, but also don't mention I don't want to be the creep. Like, anytime you're like, yo, I don't want to, like, seem creepy, it's already creepy. You've already made it creepy. Okay, this one seems like a personal conflict. Wiki Lenoka. You did say a word to me, didn't give me a chance, and a huge F you to me after all I was doing was being a friend. You're too cray to GF up, but you did me dirty. When you slip or miss my skill set, don't bother. Okay, this is an interesting post for sure. I don't know what his skill set was that she missed. I don't know how he was done dirty. But I love the don't bother at the end, because if you really want to send the don't bother message, maybe don't go fucking posting to Craigslist misconnections about it. Maybe just move on. Just miss ya, 40-year-old male seeking female. Looking for a woman that may want to share a house with me. Be good friends, or more, or less, who knows? Looking for someone who knows how to take care of a house and would enjoy sharing the responsibilities of taking care of a home. I'm a single man with a kid. I work from my home office and have a stable professional job. I'm a straightforward, to the point, kinda concise kinda guy. I don't smoke, drink, or take drugs. I don't have time to date, but I do get a bit lonely occasionally. If you'd like to chat and get to know me and see if it might be a good fit, shoot me an email and let's see where it goes. I'm open to possibilities, but not drama. Like I almost want to respect this because it seems like this guy knows what he wants. I mean, the whole, like, be good friends or more or less. So you're just going to, like, if you're not good friends with this woman, you're just going to have, like, a stranger in the house with your child. Like, I don't know if that's really the move, my guy. Lonely and I miss seeing you, Freehold. I miss the old days of Craigslist when I'd post that I'm a lonely, sexless guy who is super friendly, nice, caring, sweet, but so lonely. Being stuck in a sexless marriage to a roommate is the worst. It's been years since I had any play, and I've never had any foreplay with her. All the things I miss in life. And then the old Craigslist is gone. Anyway, if you're out there and would like to chat with this lonely, super friendly, blue-eyed, chatty guy, let me know. Please put the words lonely in your email subject. Thanks. This has me wondering, like, what were the old days of Craigslist like? Like, I don't know. It just seems like it must have been awesome, because we've got another post right after this that's also just desiring those nostalgic old days of Craigslist hookups. And, because I just don't imagine, like, how would this sort of post work? Like, just the emphasis on how lonely you are, the loveless marriage, like, none of this is getting me hot and bothered.
Ah, the old days of Craigslist personals, Tom's River. You know, I really miss the good old days of Craigslist personals. What a blast! The lovely and willing to try damn near anything uninhibited older women that I was so fortunate to meet was really quite an experience. Alas, those days are gone now. I wonder what's happened to all of the lonely and adventurous women. So many of the current ads are males. Where are the ladies? What's the Craigslist world coming to? From Asbury Park to Lanoka Harbor and all points in between, such a varied assortment of lovely and hungry willing participants. Wow, excellent times. I fear in my older age, I shall never have these wonderful opportunities again. But I truly enjoyed every second of the relationships that I was so fortunate to have discovered that can't be taken away. I would imagine that I'm destined to fade away to the vast nothingness of old age eventually and die. But again, we all did have a great deal of fun while it lasted. So long, Craigslist personals. We miss you.
If you had fucking told me today that I was gonna be reading Craigslist missed connections and I would have a person talking about fading away into the vast nothingness of old age, I would have thought you were insane. What is this post? Like, I understand this person's, like, reminiscing on these amazing times, and I wonder, I really would love to know what they were like, what these experiences, these encounters, this lovemaking, like, it must have been incredible if this person is, like, this, just happily thinking about those past times. This is one of the greatest posts I've ever seen on Craigslist in my life. Okay, I'm just into Craigslist misconnections, like the community, because this post is titled GG. This person says, it's been a long time since the AOL days. Just wondering if you're still in the area. Like, I don't know when AOL peaked exactly, like AOL Instant Messenger and all that shit. Some people watching this video might not even know what it is because it peaked in like maybe 2004 or 2005. This person's looking for somebody from like 15 years ago. Is everybody in this community like still invested in the Craigslist misconnections? Like, this is just fascinating to me. All right, this is fucking cool. I love this. I love this post so much. Freehold Mall today. Ital guy 58, gonna shop in Macy's Freehold around 1:30 today. Like to cruise in the men's section while shopping. Dude, this guy is looking for dates in the men's section of Macy's in Freehold. And he identifies as an Ital guy. Like, most of the time, people, like, you know, say their race or something, but he has to specify that he's fucking Italian, and I just love that. Oh, it's awesome. All right, this is a woman in a Cadillac. It's the woman in the Cadillac. Hey, I know you're married. I just want to give those titties the attention they deserve. I went through, North Jersey did not show up at all. Like, I originally went to the Jersey Shore to find Craigslist posts, and they were, like, pretty damn good. And then I went up to North Jersey, and everybody was just boring people they had seen at the store. But this guy, he just wants to give those titties the attention they deserve. At least he's making statements, you know? And now I would like to make a statement of appreciation for my top-tier channel members, Sir Almond Coconut, Alex Estelle, June, Matthew Kendall, Crazy Connor, Caitland, Beth the Dork, Humi, dot dot dot, Swift Wolf Coyote, Loki411, Kennedy DeSilvis, Mac in Paradise, Caleb Grills, Ghost Spoons, Roller Geeks, James Barnosky, Miss Inked, Tay P, Hyper Ninja Child, Jared D, Regrettable Stitches, Allison B, For Jared, Connor G, Cryptid Fennec, Kaya Bay, Tasha K, and Catco, as well as everyone else you see on your screen. Thank you very much. I hope everybody out there is doing super well. Let me know what kind of videos you'd like to see. Skate on to the best of your abilities. Make sure you're drinking a sufficient amount of water. And I'll see you super soon. Peace out, Cub Scouts.